स्पेसिफिकली अप टू दिस पॉइंट वी हैव क्रिएटेड कंपाइलर जस्ट लाइक ए एरर मेकिंग टूल्स और टू मेक ए फुल ऑफ कोड टू ए कंपेटेबल एनवायरमेंट. दैट मीन्स ए कंपाइलर that maps a source program into a semantically equivalent target program. Actually, this target program is designed onto the mainframe. Those, as for example, those have designed in C compiler. Which symbol table, which type of instruction, the identifier will be accepted by this target program, that depend on the that depends on the mainframe or the architecture that is provided by C language, C++ or Java language. Now if we open up this, we see that there are two parts of the mapping. One is analysis part, and another one is synthesis part. What about this analysis part? The analysis part breaks up the source program into some other part. Those are required in some essential pieces. Why it will be cut into some pieces, or why it will be segmented into some pieces? To make a grammatical structure. Already you have, suppose, write a program in C language. At the top of this source code, you need to include the directive, or you need to include the source or header file. Those are required to fulfill your requirements. Some source programs, some source functions will be there. Already there, those are defined. And after that, you need to declare the function. A prototyping is required in C language. You can define the function at the after declaring or after including all the header files or resources, and within this body we have to declare or define the main function. So this is the actual structure. Indirectly, you are going to make a segment, or you are making some pieces of code. If you not obey this type of structure, then automatically a error will be analyzed. So uses this instruction to create an intermediate representations of the program. For this purpose, if analysis part detects the source program, it's syntactically not well formed, already I have told you, and you are not maintaining the structure of the program, a prompt will be there after analysis. So the user can take corrective actions, or you need to rectify the error or the syntactical mistakes you have made there. Another task that to be performed by the analysis part, that is called the collecting of information. Collecting of information of what? About the source program and a data structure will be maintained, and that will be stored. Where it will be stored? With respect to the compiler, that will be stored onto the symbol table. And this symbol table will pass along with the intermediate representations, and this symbol table actually required for synthesis part. So what I have told you, symbol table and that will maintain some data structure for restoration. And this information already collected from the source program. In previous class already I have told you which type of symbol will be stored onto the symbol table. Which type of symbol? Already I have told you there is a very vital role of the identifier. Okay. So the symbol table specifically, suppose you have write expression and the expression is a equals to b plus c minus 50. Now tell me how a will be stored onto the symbol table. How a will be stored here? Specifically, corresponding to this variable, or after compilation, that will be treated as identifier, an ID, and corresponding to this an index value will be there. In that way it will be stored onto the symbol table. Okay, but for the constant value, simply it will be stored onto the symbol table, as because already some Unicode conversion is present there. Corresponding to this, some value is there. Those value is not exist onto your object file, not onto the source program. Does not exist onto the object file, that will be stored into the symbol table in this way.